Hello everyone, welcome back to V1 Kids News. Today I am your host, Hannah Banana, and this is my co-host, Mini Banana. Do you have any bananas on you today?
No.
No. Okay, today we are learning about how God's Spirit empowers, and we're going to take it off to Kenny K with our memory verse. Are you there, Kenny K? You there in the studio?
Hi boys and girls, teacher Kenny K here, and today's ponder point is God's Spirit empowers. And we can find our memory verse for today in Acts 1:8. So let's all stand up and go through the motions together. And we're going to run through it twice. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you. And you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem and all of Judea and Samaria and to the ends of the earth. Acts 1:8. Awesome job, boys and girls. Let's do it just one more time. But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes upon you, and you will be my witnesses in Jerusalem, in all of Judea and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth. Acts 1:8. Awesome job, boys and girls. Back to you in the studio.
Thank you, Kenny K. Wow, that was an awesome memory verse, don't you think?
Yes.
Isn't it awesome how we receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on us?
Yes.
I think it's great. Now, we have worship for you. Are you guys ready in the studio? Yes. Okay, they're ready. Let's take it on over to worship.
Yeah.
Wow, worship was awesome. Where did my co-host go?
Did I make it in time?
Yeah, where were you?
I was doing worship.
Oh, that's right. Wow, you did awesome. Good job. All right. Well, worship was awesome. I hope you guys had a great time. Now we're going to take it off to Pastor Chad, who is in the studio, and he has an awesome sermon for us, The Big God Story.
Hey, boys and girls, how you doing today? Pastor Chad back here with you for our V1 Kids online service. I'm excited for today. I hope you are. So we're going to get right into it, you know. We're going to get right back into the Big God story and how big God really is in our lives and the miracles, the things that he does, right? I mean, he goes so far. He goes above and beyond what we could ever ask and imagine because he loves us, right? So I got a question. Have you ever had to wait to do something you really wanted to do? Maybe you had to wait for your dad to finish mowing the lawn before you could go out for pizza, right? Or ice cream. Or maybe you had to wait for everyone to finish a test before you could go out for recess. Waiting isn't easy, is it? But that is how our Big God story starts today. But before we find out about the waiting part, let's ask God to help us hear what he wants us to hear today and what he wants to say. Let's pray. God, we thank you for this opportunity together. Lord, I pray that your Holy Spirit would empower us, that you would speak and we would listen. Open every heart, Lord, open every ear. And God, let us receive what you have for us this day. We want more of you, God. We thank you in Jesus' name, amen. Awesome. A few months back, we heard about, you know, in Easter time that Jesus rose from the dead and gave the disciples some important instructions. Does anybody remember what he told them before he left? Well, let's check it out. We're going to go to Matthew 28, 19 through 20, which we all know as the Great Commission. So check this out. Matthew 28, verses 19 through 20 says, "Therefore, go and make disciples of all the nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age." Yes, the Great Commission. Jesus told his followers to go make more disciples. But before Jesus went back to heaven, he had one last instruction for his disciples, really. And we're gonna find all that today in the book of Acts. Now the book of Acts is the beginning of the church. And it's right after the Gospels, which would be right after the book of John. And we're going to be in the first chapter. Actually, you can follow along with me if you got your Bible at home. And we're going to be in Acts 1. We're going to start in verse 4, 5, and then we're going to skip to 8. And we're going to see what happens here. So let's go to Acts 1, verse 4. We'll read through 5 and then jump to 8. "On one occasion, while he was eating with them," this is Jesus, okay? He had rose from the dead, right? "He comes back and he presents himself to his people. And this is what he says, 'Do not leave Jerusalem, but wait.'" Ah, there's that word, wait, right? We talked about this a little bit earlier. How many of you guys like to wait? I know I don't like to wait for things. And I'm pretty sure they were not interested in waiting either. But you know what? It's important. Let's keep going. "But wait for the gift my Father promised, which you have heard me speak about. For John baptized with water, but in a few days, you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit." Wow, that's amazing. Let's jump down to verse 8. It says here, "But you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you, and you will be my witnesses." Man, that's powerful. "In Jerusalem, and all Judea, and Samaria, and to the ends of the earth." You see, Jesus told his friends to wait in Jerusalem until the Holy Spirit came. That was what they were waiting for, right? That was the promise. Remember the promise the Father had given. But after Jesus told them all this, he left. He went to heaven. The disciples, they obeyed Jesus and went back to where they were supposed to, which was what? Jerusalem, that's right, to wait for the Holy Spirit. And they went to the upper room where they prayed and they waited for not 1, 2, 5, 6, 10 days they waited. Until the Jewish holiday of Pentecost came. You see, Jewish people from all over came to Jerusalem to worship on the day of Pentecost. There were Jewish people from Parthia, Media, Mesopotamia, Judea, Asia, Egypt even, Libya, Rome, Crete. Arabia, basically from all over that part of the world. And on the morning of the day of Pentecost, while the disciples prayed, the gift Jesus had promised to send, well, it showed up. It came. The waiting was over. That's right, the waiting, it was done. The gift was the baptism of the Holy Spirit. You see, three things happened when the Holy Spirit baptized Jesus' friends. First, Jesus' friends heard a loud sound like that of a rushing wind. Whoa, right? Crazy. Second, here's what's even crazier, what looked like tongues of fire came and rested on them. That's incredible. Can you imagine witnessing that? And not only that, but third, Jesus' friends, all 120 of them, were baptized in the Holy Spirit and began to speak in languages they hadn't learned, but as the Holy Spirit gave them the words. You see, the disciples knew. They knew that the Holy Spirit had come. Actually, we're going to go right into and read it together in Acts 2, 1 through 4. When the day of Pentecost came, they were all together in one place. Suddenly, a sound like a blowing of a violent wind came from heaven and filled the whole house where they were sitting. They saw what seemed to be tongues of fire that separated and came to rest on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other tongues as the Spirit enabled them. You see, the people in Jerusalem heard something happening and came over to find out more. I mean, wouldn't you want to, right? You heard these people speaking in all these different languages. You heard the wind. You heard all this commotion happening. But people from all over heard the disciples praising God in their languages, on all these other people's languages, right? They knew that the people speaking were from just one place. That's right, Galilee. Can you say Galilee with me? Galilee. Sounds like galloping, right? But no, it's Galilee. They could not have learned all these languages they were speaking just like that. Imagine if people from China or Russia and Spain came into the room that you were in and heard all of you speaking Chinese, Russian, and Spanish, and you'd never spoken those languages before. Crazy, right? Well, the people in the crowd knew something unusual had happened. They were witnessing God's miraculous power. But they needed more information, kind of just like we do all the time, right? So God chose Peter, you know that guy Peter we've talked about before, to speak to the crowd and explain what was happening. Peter said in Acts 2, 16 through 18, this is what he said. This is what was spoken by the prophet Joel. In the last days, God says, I will pour out my spirit on all people, your sons and daughters. They will prophesy, they will speak. Your young men will see visions, and your old men will dream dreams. Even on my servants, both men and women, I will pour out my spirit in those days, and they will prophesy. Wow, that's amazing. We're talking about something that was brought, that was spoken by a prophet before, that was coming to pass now in this day of Pentecost. And then Peter, he told the people about Jesus, God's son who died and he rose from the dead so that people's sins could be forgiven. Because that's what it was all about, right? Jesus had poured out the Holy Spirit onto his disciples. Peter also told the people that if they turned away from their sins and turned to Jesus, their sins, well, guess what? They'd be forgiven and they would receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let's go right back to the book of Acts, chapter 2. We're still in chapter 2, but we're going to go to verse 37 and 38. Let's go right into it. The Bible tells us, though, when the people heard this, they were cut to the heart and said to Peter and the other apostles, brothers, what shall we do? Peter replied, repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. Wow. Many of the people listened to Peter, and that day alone, 3,000 of them repented and believed in Jesus. You know what that would be like? That would be like us filling our building, our huge brand new worship center over there, plus more, And everybody in the building repented and gave their lives to Jesus. That's a lot of people, right? Well, that day, the Holy Spirit gave Jesus' friends power to live for Jesus and power to tell others about who he was and who he is. Remember Acts 1:8, you will receive power when the Holy Spirit comes on you. Did you know that the Holy Spirit has not changed? You know, he can still give us power to live for Jesus and that power to share the good news of Jesus with others. Let's talk about the power to live for Jesus. All of us need, all of us, not some of us, but all of us, right? All of us need the Holy Spirit's help to live for Jesus. None of us has the strength to always make right choices. You see, we need the Holy Spirit's power, but without his help, we can't tell the truth when it's hard. We can't. We can't be kind to people who aren't kind to us. And we need his help. His help to be friendly to kids who aren't different from us. To act right when we feel angry or hurt. And to obey, that's the big one, obey our parents when we don't want to. You see, we need, friends, the Holy Spirit, his power to live for Jesus. The Holy Spirit doesn't just give us power to live for Jesus. He also gives us his power to share the good news of Jesus with others. We can share the good news of Jesus and what we say and what we do. We may not preach like Peter did on the day of Pentecost, but we surely can tell our friends about Jesus and who he is. And we can share the good news. That's the gospel, right? The Bible. And the story of Jesus, the true story, and how we act. You know what? We're going to go to John. We're going to go back to the Gospel of John. I'm going to need one more scripture for you real quick, all right? So we're going to be in John 13, verses 34 through 35. This is what Jesus said right here, John 13, 34 through 35. He says, "A new command I give you, love one another as I have loved you. So you must love one another. By this, everyone will know that you are my disciples, if you love one another." Through the Holy Spirit, we have power to show God's love and to share the good news of Jesus. You see, the baptism in the Holy Spirit gives people the power to live for Jesus, to use their giftings, and the power to share Jesus with others. We'll hear more in the coming weeks about how the Holy Spirit gave people in the first church power to spread the good news in the gospel of Jesus to many people. Praise be to God, right? That the Holy Spirit, who empowers his people, lives within us. I hope you're encouraged by this story today, because without the Holy Spirit, we would be nothing. As a matter of fact, we would just be plain, ordinary people with no power to do anything. But God, he's blessed us with the Holy Spirit so that you and I, we can use our giftings to edify, to encourage the body of Christ. Not only that, we need a relationship with Jesus. You know that's the first step in order to receive the power and the gift of the Holy Spirit? So the question is this, are you willing and ready to receive that power today? And you might ask me, "How, Pastor Chad, how can I do that?" It's really simple. You know how you do it? You accept Jesus into your heart. You know what? Let's do that today. If that's you and you're watching us from across the screen right now, we can say that prayer together. All you got to do is close your eyes, bow your heads, repeat after me. And remember, the Bible tells us that if we confess and believe that Jesus is Lord and God raised him from the dead, we'll be saved. Do you believe that in your heart today? I know I do. And because of that, I'm saved. So let's say the prayer together. Father, thank you for this day. And Jesus, thank you for my life. Holy Spirit, I invite you to take over everything in my life. Please forgive me for all my sins. Wash me with your blood, Jesus. I am a sinner, and I know you are my Savior. Fill me. Tell me what to do, Holy Spirit, because I'm all yours. I need your power. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. I am so excited. If you made that prayer, please, we want to know about it. We have a connect card. You can go to visaliafirst.com/kids. There, we want you to fill that connect card out. We want to hear more about you. We want to hear about your decision. That way we can connect you and get you going on the road to discipleship. And also to learn more about who Jesus is, because that's what discipleship is, right? But we want to encourage you, if you're still watching online and maybe you're ready to come back to church, well, we are back in the building, 9 and 11 a.m. on Sundays. You don't want to miss out on all the fun. We have such a great time. It's been amazing with all of the series that we've been going through, hearing more and learning more about who God is and the identity that we have in Him. So, hey, we love you guys and we're praying for you. And continue, please, if you're still not ready to come back, continue to join us online. And remember, God is in control. We love you guys. We'll see you next time.
Wow, wasn't that a great sermon?
That was an awesome sermon about Pentecost, right?
Yeah.
And isn't it awesome how when we're baptized in the Holy Spirit, He gives us strength?
Yeah.
And He gives us strength to go show others and spread the word about God.
Yeah.
Thank you guys. Thank you, boys and girls, for watching. I hope you guys come back next week.